We have seen that the common type is paralytic squint. Whenever I say paralytic, you will think about the nerves, and there are only three nerves, that is the third, fourth and the sixth cranial nerves. Either these can get paralyzed or the neuromuscular junction can also get affected, as seen in myasthenia gravis. Okay, the most common causes are uncontrolled diabetes or uncontrolled blood pressure. Now, the picture that you're seeing here indicates a right sixth nerve palsy. How are you saying that? We know that the sixth nerve supplies the lateral rectus, right? So there's a lateral rectus palsy causing an unopposed action of the medial rectus. See, that is why the eye is moving inwards, and the most important complaint will be a massive diplopia. That is a paralytic squint, an example. Now let's look at restrictive squint. This is due to restriction of muscle movement. That can occur because of most common cause is your thyroid related ophthalmopathy, right? Now a quick revision. The first muscle to get restricted in thyroid related eye disease is inferior rectus, followed by medial rectus, superior rectus, and then the lateral rectus. And the mnemonic goes, I am so lucky. That's the order of the muscles that are affected in thyroid eye disease that causes restrictive squint. Now we are speaking so much about intermittent squint, let's learn a little bit about diplopia. It's of three types: horizontal, vertical and oblique. When I say these words, it's not the displacement of the second image, but it is the muscle that is paralyzed. In horizontal diplopia, the horizontal muscles are paralyzed. In vertical diplopia, the vertical muscles are paralyzed. And in oblique diplopia, the oblique muscles are paralyzed. This is how it appears, the image, to the patient. Okay, in horizontal, vertical and oblique. Now it is also divided into monocular or binocular. Monocular diplopia is seen when the patient closes one eye and is seen using only one eye. He can have monocular diplopia, and it is seen in cataract, aphakia, subluxated lens or keratoconus. See, all of these affect only one eye most commonly. So it causes monocular diplopia. However, binocular diplopia occurs when the patient is using both his eyes for vision. If he closes one eye, the diplopia disappears. And it is most commonly due to squint. That is because we know that for a binocular vision, both the images need to fall on the fovea of two eyes. If one image is not falling on fovea, that will cause diplopia. Okay, one is falling on a non-foveal point. One is falling on the fovea, the other image of the deviated eye is falling on a non-foveal point. That will result in binocular diplopia. Now, abnormal head posture is a compensatory gesture to reduce this annoying diplopia. The patient will start turning his head. When there is a face turn, it's horizontal muscle. When there is a chin elevation or depression, there's a vertical muscle palsy. When there is a head tilt, there's an oblique muscle palsy. Okay. For face turn, horizontal. For elevation or depression of the chin, go for vertical, and head tilt will be oblique muscle paralysis. Okay. Now, paralytic versus restrictive, how will you know if a patient is coming to you with an intermittent squint that is due to paralytic squint or restrictive squint? Let's take this example. When the patient is having an ESO deviation, ESO, right? That is an inward deviation. There are two possibilities. Either there is a lateral rectus palsy due to paralysis, or there can be a medial rectus palsy due to restrictive squint. Right? Let's differentiate these two with a test called the FDT or the force deduction test. Right? Initially, you will put local anesthetic drops to paralyze the sensations of the eye. Now, the surgeon will use two forceps and try to move the eyeball from side to side. In case of a paralytic squint, it will move. See, it is moving on this side and this side as well. there's no restriction to the movement. It indicates a negative force duction test and gives us the result of a paralytic squint. However, in a restrictive squint, see, the eye is not at all moving because the muscle is getting restricted because of, say, some trauma or fibrosis or any reason. So that is how you will differentiate between paralytic squint and a restrictive squint. Then this is called a positive force duction test. Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sai Suguna, your mentor for ophthalmology at Medicoapps. Now thanks for watching the video. Now we have put such videos all together in our ophthalmology app. The trial version you can download from the link over here or in the description box below.